Hello friends, welcome to Global Online University. Friends, in this video we are going to discuss about Jawaharlal Nehru University PhD entrance test. And friends, here you can note down the important dates. Online submission application form, it is till 27 August 2021, and last date for to pay the fees is 27 August 2021, and any correction in the application form from 1st September to 3rd September to, and then you can download admit card on 8 September 2021. The date of examination is on 20, 21, 22, 23 September 2021, and there are two shifts. The first session is from 9:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. Second session is 2:30 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. And friends, as you all know, in Jawaharlal Nehru PhD entrance test there will be two papers. One is research methodology and another one is related to our subject paper. As you all know, there will be 50 questions on research methodology. And if here from Global Online University, we are providing you crash course on paper 1 research methodology. In this crash course you will get 20 mock tests on research methodology, and you will get a PDF solution of all the 20 tests. And we are also providing you video lectures on research methodology. With this we will also get full syllabus notes on research methodology. And this crash course is available only at ₹499. If you want to join, you can contact this number. And friends, I believe that if you follow this crash course, if you follow our research methodology test, if you follow our video lectures, and if you go through these notes, it is very easy to score more marks in the research methodology, and you can also score and focus more on paper 2. Yes, let us move to the question. Yes friends, now let us move to the question. Here the question is, what is variable? Option A, construct. Option B, established relationship. Option C, hypothesis. Option D, measurable attribute. Yes, I hope you know about the variable. Variable means it is a value which is changing, such as height, age, species, exam score. For example, height will change. Yes, height is also known as the changing variable. Exam score, it is also a changing variable. Yes, sometime I may get 75 marks, sometime I may get 60 marks. In this way, the values which changes, yes, the variables which are changing are known as the variables. Here, what is variable? Variable means it is a measurable attribute. Yes, here option D, measurable attribute is the correct answer, because we can measure the change. Yes, the variables are any characteristic that can take on different values, and these values we are able to measure. So here the variables mean it is a measurable attribute. Hypothesis means, you know, it is a tentative statement. Established relationship, it means the relation between two variables. So here what is variable means measurable attribute is the right answer. Then the next question is a research hypothesis. Yes, hypothesis means, just now I have told you, it is a tentative statement which can be true and also which can be false. A research hypothesis is a option A, theory. Option B, principle. Option C, tentative proposition. Option D, postulate. Yes, here a hypothesis, it is often considered as the tentative assumption or tentative statement of the possible relationship between two or more variables under investigation. And hypothesis means it is a statement, it is a tentative statement which is given. Yes, it may be true and it may be false, and it express the relationship between two or more variables. And hypothesis does not have to be right or wrong, but the person formulating the hypothesis does have to be prepared to test the theory. Yes, hypothesis is used to test the theory. So here in this question, a research hypothesis, it is a tentative proposition. So option A is the correct answer. It is not a theory, it is not a principle, or also it is not a postulate. Hypothesis means it is a tentative proposition. Yes, the next question is, the depth of any research can be judged by. Yes, the depth of any research can be judged by option A, title of the research. Option B, objectives of the research. Option C, the total expenditure on research. ऑप्शन डी ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द रिसर्च, यस वी कांट जज द डेप्थ ऑफ द रिसर्च बेस्ड ऑन द एक्सपेंडिचर और बेस्ड ऑन द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द रिसर्च, यस द डेप्थ ऑफ एनी रिसर्च कैन बी जज्ड बाय द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द रिसर्च, यस बेस्ड ऑन द रिसर्च ऑब्जेक्टिव्स वी कैन स्टडी अबाउट द इन डिटेल स्टडी ऑफ द रिसर्च एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो जज द डेप्थ ऑफ द रिसर्च एंड वॉट डू मीन बाय ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, ऑब्जेक्टिव डिस्क्राइब what we expect to achieve by doing a research, yes what the result we are going to expect by doing this research, it is known as the objectives and research objectives are expressed in lay terms and are directed as much the client has to the researcher, yes this is about research objectives and the depth of any research it can be judged by objectives of the research, so option B is the correct answer. On the title, we can't judge the research depth of the research. So option B, objectives of the research is correct answer. Then the next question is, the result of building up information from pieces of information is called. Yes, when we are going to build an information by using pieces of information, it is called option A, an analysis. Option A, B, a synthesis. Option C, a synopsis. Option D, none of the above. Yes, synthesis analysis means breaking down the information into different parts. And synopsis means you know. Yes, it will give overall idea. So, but here option B, synthesis is the right answer. Yes, what do you mean by synthesis? Synthesis, it is the process of combining the results of multiple primary research studies. Yes, in this synthesis, we are going to combine all the information from various sources. And it may be applied to either quantitative or qualitative. Please remember this, synthesis is applied quantitative variables also and also to the qualitative variables. So, synthesis means it is combining the information from pieces of information. So, it is known as the synthesis. So, option B, synthesis is the correct answer. This is the next question is, in the process of conducting research formulation of hypothesis is followed by, yes, in the process of conducting research, formulation of hypothesis, it is followed by option A, statement of objectives, option B, analysis of data, option C, selection of research tools, option D, collection of data. Yes, in the process of research, the formulation of hypothesis, hypothesis means we have discussed in the previous slide, hypothesis means it is a tentative statement and this formulation of hypothesis is followed by selection of the research tools. So, option C, selection of research tool is the correct answer. Yes, formulating of a hypothesis requires a specific, testable and also predictable statement driven by theoretical guidance or prior evidence. And hypothesis can be formulated in various research designs. So, here selection of research tool is the right answer. The next question is, which of the following periodical is specifically meant for publishing research work? Option A, magazine, option B, monographs, option C, journals, option D, books. Books is not the right answer. So, magazine also not only meant for the research papers, monographs also not the right answer. So, here the right answer is option C, journal is the correct answer. And what do you mean by journal? Journal, it is also known as the scholarly journal. And the journal, it is a periodical. And the main aim of the journal is specialist and researchers and whatever articles are generally written by the researchers and subject using more technical language are published in the journal. They contain and these journals contain original research, conclusions based on data, footnotes, endnotes and all. So here periodical it is specifically meant for publishing research papers is option C, journals. Then the next question is, the conceptual framework in which a research is conducted is called, the conceptual framework in which a research is conducted is called, option A, synopsis of research, option B, research design, option C, research hypothesis, option D, research paradigm. Yes, Here the research design refers to the overall strategy that you choose to integrate the different components of the study in a coherent and logical way, thereby ensuring you will effectively address the researcher's problem. It constitutes the blueprint for the collection, measurement and analysis of data. Here the research design, it means it is a blueprint. Yes, it gives an idea to collect the data, to measure the data and also for the analysis of data. So here the conceptual framework in which research is conducted is called option B, research design. So option B, research design is the right answer, because it is a blueprint for our research. So it is also known as the conceptual framework. Then the next question is, formulation of a research problem depends on option A, what is the objective behind the researcher's choice? Option B, what are the specific questions? Yes, formulation of research problem depends on what is the object behind the researcher's choice. This is also correct here. Then what are the specific questions? Yes, correct. What is the conceptual model? Yes, we can say this is also right. What negative factors to research upon? Yes, this is not the right answer. In research problem, these negative factors will not be considered. Then reasons for unlimiting the study, no, this is also not right answer. Construction of hypothesis, yes, this is also true here. So here option D, A, B, C and F are the correct answer. Then the next question is, Jean Piaget gave a theory of cognitive development of humans on the basis of option A, evaluation process, option B, fundamental research, option C, applied research, option D, action research. Yes, here the Jean Piaget gave a theory of cognitive development and his theory was based on the fundamental research. So option B, fundamental research is the correct answer. Yes, what do you mean by fundamental research? It is also known as the academic research. It is also known as the experimental research. And this fundamental research, it is carried out to obtain the new knowledge on the basis of observable phenomena or facts. Yes, fundamental research, it is carried out to increase our knowledge, to obtain new knowledge, and it is based on the facts or phenomena. The next question is, a good research aims at option A, betterment of the society, option B, developing generalizations, theories and principles, option C, solving routine problems, option D, none of the above. Yes, a good research aims to express the intention or an aspiration of the research study, and the good research, it is going to summarize the single sentence what you hope to achieve at the end of the research project. Yes, the research aim should be specific. Yes, and it should be phrased in such a way that it is possible to identify when it has been achieved. Yes, so our good research always aims at developing generalizations, theories and also principles. Option B is the correct answer. Then let us move to the next question. Which one of the following is not a quality of researcher? Yes, which one of these is not a quality of researcher? Option A, unison with that of which he is in search. Option B, he must be alert mind. No, this is true. Option B, keenness in inquiry. This is also correct. His assertion to outstrip the evidence. This is also right. So here, unison with that of which he is in search. This is not the characteristic of researcher. So option A is the correct answer. Then the next question is, the core element of dissertation are, yes, the core element, the core elements of dissertation. Here four options are given. Option A, introduction, data collection, data analysis, conclusions and recommendations. Option B, executive summary, literature review, data gathered, conclusions, bibliography. Option C, research plan, research data, analysis, references. Option D, introduction, literature review, research methodology, research discussion and conclusion. And friends, this is the last question, and this question is for you to check your preparation level. I have kept this question for you. You have to comment the answer in the comment box. Yes, I wish all the best to all students. Thank you.